Hello, I'm a curator lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. A new skin capable of holding a new wine, which the university professors can't. They are old skin, full of the old wine, which is the written scripture. Scripture without the oral Torah, which is his word, is dead. That's why Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead. And here is a graphic presentation that will make it clear. Here is the scripture up. The top root is his word that Christ Jesus came to deliver. This taproot, oral Torah, lacks nothing, but this scripture, without oral Torah, they are dead. That's why Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead, as they do in the universities and colleges all over the world. Hardly anybody can go about without Bible in their armpit. If you ask them a question, they will open the Bible, read a passage, then there's a cross-reference, they go there, make you fed up. Themselves, they don't know anything. But the gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart, through logical reasoning. No capability of logical reasoning, no gospel. Gospel is as simple as ABC. Still, it is only by the grace of our supernatural Father that you are given the gospel. You long for gospel, you get it. If you don't long for gospel, you don't get it. So you must have a desire to know gospel. And in 93 I studied the New Testament. In 1995 or so I wrote this book, First Gnostic Principle of One God, One Faith. It is all written in spirit, not by the dead letters that you read this book, that book, and then you vomit it out in a book. This is the two kingdom, kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis in law and order. That ended with John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16. Afterward, Jesus opened the narrow gate to the royal kingdom of God, which is in your heart and not in your, in the book or head. So, the Samaritan people, they were generation of Joseph. They were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, and they were the salt of the earth, a nation of prophets. That's why Jesus said, many prophets were sent to you, and you beat them, you killed them, maltreated them. And then, God sent you a nation of prophets, which are the Samaritans, and they hated them. They killed Jesus because they loved darkness. That's why the good news was broken to the shepherd in the field who were not drunk with the old wine. Their hearts were clean. They had common sense, which the university professors don't have common sense. To give you a simple example, a Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual self, not physical self, outwardly. Outwardly they are tribal, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, Jat. In India, we are Jat tribe. Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, all split yourself inside here. Never born, never die. Tribal people are born, tribal people die. So during the Holocaust, not a single Jew died. Or in India, 1947 or 84, riots, not a single Hindu or Sikh or Muslim died. But the tribal people were born, tribal people died. And my father knew this subject. 2,000 people came to attack our village. And when he told them that we tribal people going to kill each other, not Sikh and Muslim, the headman understood it, and he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, which they did. So my father was giving this knowledge to other people, like the people in Jerusalem. They were lured by the head priest in the temples. And remember, Jesus cured lepers. A leper, after being cured, they run back to their rabbi to sit in the front of the temple. They left Jesus, who cured them. That means they were saltless people. They did not appreciate what Jesus had done. Whereas Samaritan man, when he was cured, he returned back to Jesus to thank him and accompanied him to know more about such thing. He was customer for the knowledge. But Jesus told him, go home. You don't need. Your people are already know this thing. Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he showed mercy. And mercy is the highest quality a person can possess to be part of God. Our Father is merciful, loving and merciful. However, a little something, and then I will, here I can explain this one. This is below John the Baptist. He baptized the Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. That's why his name was Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua means the primordial Adam. Jesus was second Adam, floating. He came floating, he went away, taking his body away as well. So these people, about 20 to 25 years old, when they realized that what the temple priests are doing, making them Jew outwardly of appearance, quantity, not quality of heart. They came through John the Baptist, Prophet Elijah, the cornerstone of the temple, who were ousted out by the hypocrite temple priest. Because hypocrites deliver sugar-coated sermon and they make a great following. And when they make great following, then they are dangerous. Christ Jesus with the word of God. Hypocrisy is exposed through word of God. And Tony Blair and Bush, they said Saddam Hussein had weapon of mass destruction. A major general, army major general, he went to Iraq after the destruction. And he found not true. There were no weapons of mass destruction. And he is running a ministry, international ministry, Christian ministry. And he delivered a sermon in Reading to the Christian men's breakfast, and I was there. The people asked him, did Saddam Hussein help weapon of mass destruction? He said, none at all. And then I gave me this card, you know, and after, you know, I wrote to him, if you know this gospel truth, why not proclaim it from the rooftop that Tony Blair and Bush, they are blasphemers and war criminals, destroying one country after the other. This man, maybe he was bound like centurion by the head of their thing that they can't disclose anything, any fact. In Jesus, like Nathaniel, what is inside should be outside, no duplicity. This Data Protection Act and all that, they are antichrist, in which the thief is given full protection instead of being exposed. No wonder the country, Britain, has become a country of crooks. No justice. If you go in a country where there is no law, people go by spirit in the African jungles. Such things don't happen over there. They speak the gospel truth. Putin, a man of God, son of man, tribal man. Now he's speaking the gospel truth. That they want to take over the Ukraine because Ukraine is bringing NATO and all those people at the very home of him. So these people, which are blasphemers, remember that there are two things, you know. One place is God, other place is Mammon. Mammon is of Satan, blood sucking. You acquire Mammon by cheating people. So these Jewish people in America, they are full of blood money, not honest people. In Russia, you have tribal people. Over there, they don't cheat people as they do it in America. So they have very little blood money in that. Most people are tribal. And this planet Earth is for the tribal people, not for Jew, Hindu, Sikh, or Muslim, or Christian. They are tears, sons of the Most High Satan. They will fight and kill each other. And you see them in Israel now. So, gospel cannot be written on ink on paper. It is given to thee by God to those who are longing for gospel and who are not frightened of the word. They will speak out the gospel truth. These people who are under the domination of the other people, they are not free men like the centurion. So these people, they cannot open their mouth because it will offend the other people. Like this, Jew is a spiritual self inwardly, not outwardly. Outwardly, Judah tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, so and so. So during the Holocaust, Hitler did not kill a single Jew, but the people who were blind guide, leading the blind follower, as they were in the temple, who asked for the death of Jesus. It was those sinners which Hitler killed. Hitler killed the sinners and Putin is going to kill the blasphemers, which is not forgivable. Blasphemy against Holy Spirit is punishable by God. So by God are the people who will kill them. They are sons of man, tribal people. And that is where the Russia comes. They have more tribal instinct than any other country. So they will sort them up and they will teach them a good lesson for uttering the blasphemy and destroying one country after the other. What Saddam Hussein or Gaddafi had done to America? Nothing. And Saddam Hussein was killed under darkness, under the cover. He was Lamb of the God, like Christ Jesus. But they, Mormon media, painted a black picture, gave a dog a bad name and kill him. And that is what they did. So bad dog, they gave them from the core of their heart, while he was a good man. He was of my same tribe as me, Jat tribe, Khokhar Jat. We are not bad people. We are farmers and we are honest people. You will hear many stories now of Saddam and how he punished his own son for misbehaving. So of course he was strict, you know, these people, America, they are idol makers. And one of the politicians, she displayed these Americans as a troublemaker, and this cartoon published by the Jewish newspaper. And I happen to make a copy. So it is a Jewish, this man, Jewish man. Sickle has David's cross. That means the Jewish people in America, they are the ones who are bringing bloodshed one after the other. And Ukraine is also, she mentioned here. Iraq, everywhere. So this is a good summary of what is happening. The most of the politicians, they know it, but they are lacking the knowledge of gospel, the gospel truth, because they have to speak sugar-coated sermon from their mouth to win votes. If they say that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, they won't get any vote at all. The Germans, they have made it a crime if somebody denies that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. It's a punishable. And they have become hypocrite. Hitler, a tribal man, German, he sorted them up. And here you are the present politician. What Hitler did, they are undoing his work. They are blaming him. This planet is for the tribal people, not for Hindu, Sikh, Muslim or Jew, spiritual people. They were all kill each other. So you will see soon what will happen. So here I want to stress, you know, that these in the universities and colleges I go, Oxford University is nearby, and when I tell them the gospel truth, their ears are full of wax, hardened wax of the dead letters. They don't want to know the new gospel. So gospel is not for these people of dead letters, as they were in Jerusalem. The good news of the birth of Jesus was broken to shepherd in the field. whose skin was brand new. They haven't gone to study theology in the Jerusalem University. They were illiterate. And such are the people who will get the gospel because they have a new skin, not these university professors. They will hate gospel. So hireling doxologists in the churches, they are like Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. Judas Iscariot was thrown out at the Last Supper because he was not suitable candidate to enter the royal kingdom of God, where you don't take any money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tunic, and no scrip. Bible is forbidden. Because our covenant in the New Testament are up above is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. So here John the Baptist baptized them in the name of Abraham and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And the tribal seed, the ego of the tribal seed is to be sown here before you can knock on the door of our royal kingdom. So those people who long for gospel, that is the age of 25 to 30, when they were made the sons of man, salt of the earth, by making them sons of Abraham, they have to put that seed, tribal seed here, and put it in the soil, make it to disappear. Remember, if you have a wheat seed when you put it in, or tomato seed, then a plant will come. The identity of the seed will be implicit in the plant. By looking at the plant, you will say, this is a wheat plant, this is a tomato plant. But the seed itself will not produce fruit. That's why St. Paul said, don't put your seed, tribal seed, on the mantelpiece and keep on praising that my forefather was king, my forefather was so and so. Put that seed into the soil so the ego of that seed disappears, because ego is the enemy of spirit. So when ego has been killed and the seed has been turned into a plant which is twice born bearing fruit, then you knock at the door and you enter into the royal kingdom of God. And here our soul is concerned and not flesh. Soul represents our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Abram, which we call God. God is spirit. So in spirit we have the covenant with Christ Jesus in Holy Spirit, not by the dead letters of the Bible. So Bible is forbidden here. So these people are in John 3, Nicodemus, Jesus stressed that you people, to Nicodemus, teachers of the moral law, they teach them the written Torah, but old written Torah, as they are teaching the dead letters in the universities and colleges today. I call the university professors super donkeys carrying holy books. And one of the professors, he retorted that in Oxford University, we are to teach the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament, the interpretation of the scripture is up to the student. Not we can't give them the interpretation. And he's right. Because interpretation comes by the grace of our supernatural Father. no man can give you. Christ Jesus could not give gospel to Peter. That's why he was called stone. Stone dipping in water soaks nothing. Same in the company of Jesus. Peter soaked no gospel at all. Only when he was rewarded the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, then his jump was greatest from once born to thrice born of Holy Spirit with capital S. And then he opened his mouth and started preaching gospel. Otherwise he was going to the temple keeping his mouth shut and not speaking to anyone. So that is the type of Jesus one, people who are truthful. If you speak the truth, this secular truth, whatever you see with your two naked eyes, this, like this one, these people, this you see them naked eye, you should know them who they are by their tribes. As under Hitler, people were German. Same in England, when the English were English, not Labour or Conservative or so and so, sons of Satan. Then they killed the Jewish people, the tares, sons of Satan. Blindness is so great in this world. In 1947, you can see all the people of the same blood, relative, close relative, how they parted from each other under the cover of religion, or when they became super bastards. And like super bastards, they killed each other. I lived in Ghana. Over there, people have tribal mark on their faces. So, the circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Nobody else can have it. But the Jewish people, priests, when they entered the Church of God, or when they were in the temple, they were circumcising Gentiles, slaves, and other people to increase their disciples. The disciple pay tithe to the rabbi to increase their income, money. They increase the number of Jews under them. So those people who are from India or from Pakistan or from Iran, they are circumcised now. When the Jewish people, they enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, they bring in all the temple practices and they polluted it. Whereas in the church, they wanted to bring in the circumcision, it was rejected. So, the Jewish people were making Jew outwardly through circumcision and then proclaiming, no, you are son of Abraham. How could they become sons of Abraham if somebody come from Russia, he is Aryan, or German, who is Aryan, or Iran people, Aryan. How could they become sons of Abraham? A Semitic race. No way. So you can see people do not know what they see with the two naked eyes, the men around them. If you do not know what you can see with two naked eyes, then you cannot know our supernatural Father, which cannot be seen but perceived. Perceived. That's why Jesus said, they see the dead letters written in the Torah, but they do not perceive the root of the dead letters, the oral Torah, which is His word, and that Jesus came to deliver, and they killed Him because they love darkness. So this is the place where no Bible is allowed. Here we are all sons of God. No woman here. That's why St. Thomas said, unless a female, here people are disciple of the rabbis, disciple of John the Baptist. Disciples are not free men. They are under their teacher. So here the teacher suppressed their ego. We sorted out their ego. And here He sorted out the greed criteria. Greed is the dominant sickness. The Samaritan woman at well, having five husbands, those five are the spiritual ailments or sicknesses which need to be cured to enter the royal kingdom of God. And they are well known in India. They are calm, immorality, growth, anger, lobe, greed, moh, worldly attraction, and hankar, haughtiness, proud of. As the university professor are proud of their degrees. I've got doctoral degree, double doctorate, triple doctorate, this and that. So she had overpowered all of these ones. She learned the subject of religion through Holy Spirit, not through the dead letters of the books. So she was better off than the Jewish people who read Torah, written Torah day and night without understanding it, as they do today in this country, all over the world. So they don't know who was born, who died. Then they cannot know God. First know what you see, then what is not seen will be known to you through perception, through perceiving. So, there's something I've written, and I hope you will enjoy it. I explained most of the salient points. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Pabram, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim Allah Pabram, that dwells within His temple of God. This is the temple of God. So He is no more alienated in heaven. As in churches they say, our Father in heaven. They are spiritually super blind. St. Paul said that our Father is no more alienated in heaven. He is inside here. And they still believe in Him in heaven because their teacher, the Docolo priest, who is Judah Iscariot in sheep's clothing, a thief, a crook, Antichrist, he is telling them that our Father is in heaven, not in here. So you can cheat people as you like. You can tell lies as you like it. As Tony Blair and Bush said that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction, but none were found. So, gospel, for gospel to receive, you need a clean heart, so the God can come in and rest. Clean heart is one which is not greedy. Like St. Paul, he was earning his living as a tent maker. He was not living on the tithe of the people. Here in Reading, there's a church, you know, of black people, where the Jamaican and Negro all go there, most of them, and they have established tithe in the church. The priest is taking tithe. That priest is no better than those rabbis from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. So he is binding them again, and he is living lavishly on the tithe. They are Antichrist. So if I go there, he won't entertain me. I have been thrown out from his conference in a seminar in Oxford University on Christian and Jew. It was 2 days, and I went late, and I attended the first lecture. Then a lady came who was organizing that. She was the priest over there. She called me, come, come. So I went out to see her. She said, you can't sit in this conference with this hoodie on. What is written on this hoodie, students don't like it. I said, this is the light or living lampstand. That's why Jesus said, you know, if you have light, put it on the lampstand, so nobody will stumble. So before they knock on my shoulder, they will be interested what I preach. I can explain to them, that is the customer, this is my net to catch the fish. I'm the fishers of men, spiritual men, who may be men in flesh or a woman in flesh. So far in soul, they are independent. Solitary, they are men, not going by what I say or somebody else say. Such people are solitary men. They are capable of entering through the narrow gate. So this narrow gate here is a, only one person can go. Like Sadhu Melchizedek, this is the word of Sadhu Melchizedek, celestial word of soul. So soul has no gender, male or female, but Jew or Gentile, but it represents our Father. Father is like sun. If you see sunshine outside, that represents sun, that it came from sun. Same way, if I preach gospel, when you preach gospel, you are preaching it from your own heart, not what Jesus said, this man said, that man said. Listen to everyone and wet it by Holy Spirit. So I listened to Jesus, I wet it. The Jewish people have made corruption in that one. Jesus had no disciples. He had laborers, workers. The root of the word disciple is discipline, which the rabbi Pharisees do the discipline by teaching the moral law of Moses. They had disciples, not in Christ Jesus. We don't have disciples. Each, everyone has to give his own account to God. So, here is something. Elohim that dwells within his temple of God. created by the demiurge potter, the greatest artist, the lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, etc., the greatest architect of all. And it is called Har Mandir. Har means God, Mandir means temple, or Immanuel. God is with us in our heart. God teaches me. I listen to God. Through logical reasoning, He will teach me. Then I will vomit out what my father says. It is right. Then it is like representing sunshine. That sunshine comes from sun. Same way, these what we speak, gospel, we speak what pleases our Father. So it comes from our Father. And we make mistake, then our Father will rebuke us and put us on the right path. We don't need to ask a man. But if there are two or three gathered together in the name of Christ Jesus, then Christ Jesus is sitting among us. Then something I miss, somebody else will find it. Then we all together, we start preaching gospel. Okay. Let's see. Her mother Emmanuel, according to Christ Rajinder. My name is Rajinder. I preach Christianity. I'm not a Christian. Christians of the book are here. Down. Scripture. That finished with Luke 16, verse 16. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. Afterward, Jesus opened this. The gate to the royal kingdom of God, which has narrow gate, and it is the purely spiritual world. So, it's a purely spiritual world here. Here we have one Father, God. We are all sons. Son represents father and not the daughter. So no daughter here. We are all sons. And we love each other, which is called agape. In Punjabi we call prem. Prem and agape, same thing. I'm very lucky that we have the second coming of Jesus in the name of Nanak, where I was born. It was only within 50 miles. So our people believe in Sikhism. Whereas those people who are clever people, like the temple priest, they believe the dead books. And that's why Jesus and I call them, let the dead bury their dead. So it's Christ Rajinder, not Nijjar. Because Nijjar, my surname, it drops down. It's purely spiritual world. So here the people are Christian because they read scripture as they taught by the universities and colleges. Here they are Christian, they produce Christian, dead in letters. Here, people who are living in Holy Spirit, they will go. They have the love for God, and they will enter through this narrow gate. They will tell their parents, their relatives, that He is going there, and they have nothing to do with Him. So, let's see. In Jesus, we are fishers of men, scripture men, twice born, and not of women. Women are disciples of the Rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, as Saul was disciple of Gamaliel. Whatever Gamaliel told him, he did it against his own conscience. We are fishes of men and not of women. Women cannot be fished because they go by what their Rabbi, Pharisee, Sadducee tell them. Only you need to be solitary, independent, master of your own destiny, as John 9, born blind person was. So unless a female means disciple of the Rabbi, who has learned the scripture, becomes a male, as Saul became male after the Damascus experience, lightning, twice born. So she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God, of souls. How would a female become a male? Your bishop in Mammon, you know this thing, there somebody wrote an article recently, 20 pages, 30 pages. How a woman can become a man? How would a female become a male? Your bishop in Mammon cannot know this simple gospel. That's why in Jesus we are fishers of men and not of women. Men are those who are solitary in Christ Jesus. They could be in flesh, male or female, doesn't matter. So far you represent him, you are male. So let's see. Male, your bishop in Mammon cannot know. When I told your priests that they are thieves of the order of Judas Iscariot, he reported to the office, and next time I was shunted out. I went to Protestant Christian Tag in Germany. It was in Berlin in 2017. Over there we were sitting on the table in the overseas visitors, you know, room. And there are three or four of us were talking and discussing. So I told them, you know, Judas Iscariot was thrown out at the Last Supper because he was stealing money from the purse which the people donated, and he was stealing money. As in the church, people donate money to the church, and this docker priest at the end of the month, he steals that this is my salary. Whereas the first laborers of Jesus, they have sold all their possession to qualify to enter the royal kingdom of God. So you can see what they are doing now. So let's carry on. So Judas Iscariot, so that one of the young priests from Denmark, you know, he was. When I told him that you are a thief, you were just taking money from the church purse of Judas Iscariot, he went to the office over there and told them that this man is calling me a thief. And the lady from that office then came, you know, tell me, don't give any literature to anyone before it is signed by the office. Blind guy signing a paper. So that is how they were, you know. So next year when in Dortmund, so I sent the money well in advance and everything for private accommodation. And they put me in school with the youngsters. Bring your own pot, bring your own spoon, and cook your own meal and sleep rough with the youngsters. Then I said, if you don't honor me, if you don't value what I say, I'm not coming to your kitchen talk. So I asked them to refund my money, which they did. And I lost money on travel ticket. Not much, but still, you know, it was on their behavior. Or they shunted me out of the kitchen talk, throw me out of the kitchen talk. This is an organization of mammon. That is why blasphemers prosper in such an organization. And now Putin is going to sort them up. Now be ready to receive the beating from Putin for uttering the blasphemies that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. And Gaddafi, what wrong he did? You bloody killed him. You are war criminals. God won't let you go. God will punish you proper. So, priest that they are thieves of the order of Judah Iscariot, he reported this to the office. And next time I was shunted out. In Dortmund, you put me in school, whereas I had paid for the private accommodation in the kitchen tower. You know, they say, oh, it's all full, gone. No private accommodation. Those who loved Christ Jesus sold their worldly possessions to join hands with him. And today, you have priest working for mammon and hating God. So when you work for mammon, you hate God. That's why those people who preach gospel, they hate them. Worse than the temple priest for hating Jesus. The temple priest were asking Jesus question. And they were, so were those people who were men of letters. They were asking questions to Jesus, although they were blind guides of the blind. So this now nobody asked me questions. These priests, they think this India man, black man, he has no knowledge. We white people have the knowledge. They are racist of the first degree. And I have experienced a lot of racism from the British people. If anybody is there to help me, I will present my cases to him. We are priests working for mammon, hating God. Remember Christ Peter, the gatekeeper, asked Ananias and Sapphira to speak out the truth, secular truth, which conceives through your naked eye. If you speak the truth, then you will love the absolute truth. If you are a liar, then you will love blasphemy, like Tony Blair and Bush. But they speak blasphemy of the same order as Tony Blair and Bush told the public that Saddam Hussein had weapon of mass destruction, but none but none were found. A blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, and he prepared to face Putin. And we prepared to face Putin, a man of God, for proper punishment befitting the blasphemy against God. Those who turn to God and proclaim from the rooftops the gospel truth, for what reasons the USA and the West killed Saddam Hussein and Gaddafi, would take the side of God. They will take the side of God if they proclaim from rooftop, and not like this major general. He's a hypocrite of the first degree, side of God. Whilst those who hide it shall face the wrath of Elohim Allah Abram, our supernatural Father. Sins are forgivable, but not blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. Watch my over 8,300 videos on channel One God, One Faith. I hope you enjoy it. I'm sorry, I make lengthy videos because most of these things I have to repeat it to make you understand it better. I hope you will forgive me. Our Father in above heaven. He is not in heaven. He is above heaven. Remember when John the Baptist baptized Jesus, not Christ, Jesus. Then the heaven opened up. Heaven opened up. The voice came from above heaven that this is my son, listen to him. So our supernatural Father is not in heaven, but he is above heaven, which is the, you can't see. You can't see. That is what the Greek people said to the unseen or unknown God. Unknown God. What you see with the two naked eye, you can, prophets and all those you can see, are what is written in the Torah or the holy books you can read. But of God, it is hidden at the top root of the tree of scripture. So you have to perceive. And to perceive, you have to have need common sense, which is Holy Spirit. We call it Surti. No Surti, no common sense, no gospel but dead letters. That's why when Maggie came to Jerusalem, Herod and the temple priest, they colluded with each other. They wanted to know from Maggie where Christ is, where Jesus, Christ in the name of Jesus was born. But she knew, Maggie, that they are against him. So visit to Jerusalem is to confirm that the men of dead letters, they hate people of Holy Spirit. When they preach gospel, what is not written in the books. And what is not written, they can't understand. They only understand what this man say, that man say, and they write a paper, reproduce it. I write a paper from the core of my heart with no reference I need. I quote sometimes Bible to stress it, and Jesus has done. They don't want to know me. That is, in, you are not academic. You haven't got MA or PhD in theology. So our Father God blesses you. Atomic war is end of this November. In November is coming when Israel is 75 years old. Then there is no protection to it. 6 months of intensive work. In the seventh month, the middle candle of menorah of Elohim will be the atomic war. Our Father knows better than me, a stupid man. So we leave it here, and I close the video. Oh dear, where is it going?